Hi there and welcome to this video. In this video, you're going to learn how to use Hetzner DNS. If you want to manage your DNS using Hetzner, this video is for you. The first things you're going to need, first off, you need your registrar's login, your domain registrar, because this is where you're going to change the name server so that it can point to the name servers for Hetzner. If you come here, this currently uses the name servers for Cloudflare. We're going to see how we can change that once we add our zone to Hetzner DNS. The next thing I'm going to need, and you're going to need as well, depending on your use case, is a control panel. If you're using Cpanel, Hestia, Cyberpanel, whatever you're using to run your website, you're going to need that so that you can add your website and have it showing online. In this case, I'm using Webuzo just for demonstration purposes, and I'm going to add my domain here at some point, so that we can see that the domain is working online. Even if you're not using a control panel, if you install your domain directly on a server, just get the IP address for the server. And as long as you have a server software like Nginx, Apache, Lightspeed, everything should be able to work as long as you've configured them properly. To make my work easy, I'm using a control panel for the demonstration. So first things, let's go to Hetzner and I'm going to add a zone. So the zone is the domain that you want to use with Hetzner DNS. If you're not already on this page, just come up here and somewhere here you're going to see DNS. Click on it and it's going to get you to this page. All right, so let me add my zone. I'm going to click there on add new zone. I'm going to enter my domain name there without any spaces. Make sure you don't have any white space. And then I'm going to choose the first one because we're going to add our records manually. If you have a zone file, you can import your zone file right there. Hopefully it is compatible with Hetzner. We'll go with the first one. I'm just going to click on it and then auto scanning records. So assuming that your domain is currently online and you just want to migrate your DNS to use Hetzner, then leave this enabled because it's going to scan the current DNS records that are publicly available for your domain. But in my case, I'm just going to disable this because the domain is not being used and I don't want to bring in any DNS records. So I'm going to disable that and then click on continue. And now the next step, so I'm just given some default options that I can go with, like mail, www, a record for my website, and that's it. If I need to add any other records, I can add them now or I can add them later. For now, I'm just going to add my IP address. So the IP address for your server where your website will be hosted, get that and use that. If your server is also on Hetzner, if you click there, it's going to show you the IP addresses that you currently have and you can select one of them. So in my case, I'm just going to paste all these different IPs. If you have a control panel, just use the same IP used on your control panel. And then at some point, we're going to need to add this to our domain registrar. For now, I'll just leave them as they are. So as it is, I don't know that I need to change this. Let me just see if I click continue, it's going to work. Okay, you can see my zone has been created. If you receive any error, try reloading the page and then try again. Sometimes the Hetzner DNS is just like that. You just try again and it's going to work. So there you go. It's telling you there's an action required. You need to change the name servers. And the name servers you need to change are this. It's even telling you the current name servers. So you need to add this name servers to your domain registrar. So that's the next step. The next step, let's copy this and add them to our domain registrar. Whichever registrar you're using, just go to their platform. You're going to find a place where you can change the name servers for your domain. So this time round, I decided to use this provider, but I usually use Namecheap for most of these demonstrations. So if you don't know how to do it with Namecheap, I did a video about Cloudflare. You can find that with Namecheap and it will be a similar process. Name server. Let's paste in the first name server. And then the second name server. Paste that in as well. And then the third name server. I will paste that as well, and then I will update the name server. Okay, just remove the period at the end. And then try again to update the name server. All right, just give it time to propagate, and then it should be reflected on your Hetzner zone. So I'm just going to click finished, go to dashboard. So I can edit the zone file. I don't want to edit it manually, but if you want to export this file and use it somewhere else, you can do so here. I'm going to cancel that. And if I scroll down, I can change the TTL for this, and I can make that 60 seconds. I want to change it for all this, save and save. You can edit the zone file manually. You can look at your name servers. Let's see. There are your records. If you need to add the records, you can add a new record here. And we're going to see how to do this once the domain propagates. We're going to see how we can add maybe a subdomain and so on. And you can look at the settings. For that, you can delete the zone if you don't need it. And you can change the default zone time to live there. Let's see where the domain goes to. It is not propagated yet. You should give it some time to propagate. You can search name server check. We'll go with DNS checker. Show NS records. So it's still using Cloudflare, but just give it time and it should propagate to Hetzner. Okay, so it's been about 5 minutes, roughly. Let me just come back here and I will try again. Show NS records. It's still showing the ones for Cloudflare. Let's try to use a different. Let's use Cloudflare DNS server. Show NS records. And you can see in some places it's propagated, and in others, it hasn't. DNS propagation happens in sequences. So it may start in servers in Europe. Once it has updated that, it will go to US, Asia, Africa, and so on. And that's how it happens. It has to delete all the cache, and then it replaces it with the new details so that the next time somebody requests for that domain, it is going to get the latest records. So it takes time. That's why sometimes it takes a long time, depending on your DNS provider. Right now, I'm sure if I was to use a VPN, I'll probably find that there are certain places where the domain has propagated. So I'm going to use the Opera browser. So if I was to enable VPN, and I will choose a location, Europe, location as Europe. And let's see if the domain has propagated. So you can see if I check the domain in another region like Europe, it has propagated. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add the website regardless. So once the domain propagates and you're sure it has propagated, just go to your panel and you can add your website. Click on add domain, and we're going to add that domain to this panel. Depending on the panel that you're using, just add the domain, and you can add it as a packed domain, add-on domain. So I'm just going to add it as an add-on domain. Give the domain a name. Remove any white spaces. I will leave that path at default. I will not enable that, and I will leave Let's Encrypt certificate. So if the domain is propagated, Let's Encrypt should also be issued without any problem. And then I'm just going to click on add domain. So the domain was successfully added. if you go to the DNS records, I'll go there, DNS zone settings. Actually, you can search for anything here. So I can just search for DNS. And it's going to show you the zone for that, but I want to see the zone for this. So what you'll do, now that you have this DNS records here that your server has generated for you, what you'll need to do is copy them one by one. You'll copy them one by one and add them to Hetzner. We already have an A record. We don't have an IPv6 record. And all these other records, you can add them. Like this one, you don't need to add this because we're not using our server for DNS records. So we can leave that. We can leave that. This one as well. Any record that you're going to need, you can just add it. Or here, copy them and add them, especially this ones. If you're sending mail using your server, make sure you add this ones, and we're going to see how to add that in a moment. We can go to the file manager and change something, and you're going to see that the domain is actually working. So if you go to the file manager, I want to go into this domain. I can just create a new file here. New file, new HTML document. I can call it index.html. So even without putting anything inside of that file, that should change the content of this page. And you can see it's now a blank index file. And we can even add something in here, edit. I'm just going to use TinyMCE. It's sort of a small visual editor. So we can say, hey there, Saya. And we can change that into heading one. Click on save. And if we come back and reload, there we go. Our page is working, and it's working using Hetzner DNS. So it's just a question of patience. You wait for the DNS to propagate, and it's going to get propagated in all the regions. Like right now, where I am, it has not propagated, but in certain regions, it has propagated. So I'm just going to refresh and see if anything has changed on this end. Okay, so here as well, it has not reflected, but in certain regions, it has reflected that our domain is being handled by Hetzner. So to add the other records, you can add all these other records. So whether you're on cPanel, just find your DNS zone with the correct domain, and then you can add them to your Hetzner account. Like the DMARC records, I can add the DMARC record for that, copy, come back to Hetzner and edit the zone file. Let's just start from here. So I'm going to click on edit the zone file. And I'm going to cancel that. I want to edit it using this visual editor. And I want to add a record. So to add records like this, you can see it is a TXT record. So you need to add a TXT record. So for the DMARC, we're going to add a TXT record. Let's come back, search for TXT. The name, that there is the name. And then the value or the record is here. The best way is just to click on edit so that it can give you the full record. Control A, copy, bring it back here, put the value in there, paste it, and then update the value. And then add the record. Come back. Let's add another TXT record. Like this one, I can see it's a long one for DKIM. So DKIM, these are important for mail. That's why I'm showing them as examples. So I'll copy the name there. And it is also a TXT record. And you can add it the same time as that. The same time to live, time to live. Or you can just leave the default on Hetzner. The default on Hetzner is that, but you can change them here. So we're going to add another TXT record. We have the name. And we want to get the value, so I'll click there on edit. The one I need is this. So I'm going to click there on edit. Control A, Control C to copy everything. And I will come back and I will paste that in there. So the reason I was choosing to edit it is because I need to copy the entire thing without leaving anything out. Then I'm going to update the value there and add the record. So that's basically how you add all these other records. If you need to add another record, like this A record here, so I'm going to copy that and I will add it as an A record. Just come back to Hetzner. Add an A record. The name of the record is that. The value is your IP address. A records usually take IP addresses, so you're going to use that. Add the record like that. Okay, so the next step, let's see how you can add a subdomain. Say we want to add a subdomain like blog, enter. So continue. You can see the site cannot be found because the DNS records don't exist. So let's come back here and let's see how we can add blog dot our domain on Hetzner. Right, so as always, let's just go and start from the beginning. Let's say you want to add blog dot, for that you'll just come in here, click on edit zone file. So let's just reload, console. So we need to add an A record for blog and we're going to use our IP address for that. Add record. And if you need to add the www version of it, you can do so. And I'm going to add that as a CNAME record. So I'm going to add www.blog. And the value will be, the value for this will be blog.mycoupons.com. So that's the www version of a subdomain. And then I will add the record. So right now, if we go there, let's see if by any chance it has propagated. No, it hasn't. So let's try and see if it has propagated on this end. Paste and go. So on this end, you see it has propagated, so it's working fine. So everything is just about time. Just give them time to propagate. I believe I've given you all the information you need to work with Hetzner DNS. If you need to add another domain to your control panel, just come in, follow the same steps I did for adding this domain, add the domain. And after adding the domain, you're going to have to go to whoever is your domain registrar, change the Nameservers to the ones for Hetzner DNS. And then once you add the domain to your control panel, go to your DNS zone. You can just search whichever panel you're using, see how you get to your DNS records for a specific domain. And then copy the domains from here and bring them to Hetzner. And the name of the domain is there, the type of the domain. You also need to put the correct type of the domain, whether it's an A record, CNAME record, TXT record, MX record. At the end, I have to give you some advice if you want to use DNS. The one that I always recommend is Cloudflare because it comes with various security features. If you don't need those security features, or for some specific reason you need to use a different provider, maybe due to data regulations, maybe you're in Germany and you just want to use a German company for this, then you can use Hetzner. But usually just go ahead and use Cloudflare. And I do have a Cloudflare DNS tutorial that I just did recently, and that should be enough to guide you. This video has covered everything you need to work with DNS. The next one I want to do is DNS on DigitalOcean. If that's something you're interested in, you can watch out for that video. I will do that one as well. See you next time.